Focus up, boy. Focus up. Look here, another.
Oh, look! It's Skoll and Ahti, the giant wolves who chase the sun and moon.
Quite right, my boy.
Where did they come from? How did they get up there?
Why, it's a long story, but we'll get to it.
What's happening there at the end? They eat the sun and moon? And then everybody fights?
I suppose that's one way to put it.
Atreus, to me! Is over.
next to Mother's garden this whole time. No wonder we can never get in there. Amir, what else did the serpent tell you when you spoke? Kinda sounded important.
I'm sure it's nothing. He just said the boy seemed familiar to him.
Me? That's impossible.
No, I quite agree. Unless, perhaps, he refers to something yet to be. It is said that when Jormungandr and Thor battle at Ragnarok, their clash so violently shakes the Tree of Life that it splinters, casting the serpent backward through time, even before his own birth.
What?
That is madness.
Well, I did say not to concern yourself.
Boy.
Sir. Okay. That's going in the journal.
Mess.
Why is Odin so desperate to find a way into Jotunheim anyway?
He's convinced the giants hold the key to changing his fate when Ragnarok comes. They are the Aesir's oldest enemies, after all. And it's their army that's supposed to do him in the end. But more than that, he covets their gifts of prophecy. He wants to know what they know and see what they see. So much suffering could have been avoided if his insatiable curiosity was not so much stronger than his wisdom. Ah, remind me to tell you why they call him the Lord of the Hanged.
Have you made it out of Fafnir's storeroom yet?
Reavers.
Uh-oh. They must have gotten here first. Reavers made it inside. I hope they didn't take all the treasure. Treasure, and no whetstone.
Keep your expectations low, boy, and you will never be disappointed. Caught you off guard.
I wasn't expecting them.
Exactly. Sources. The main reason we are here, boy. However, many of these chests have been emptied.
Probably by the Reavers. I hope they didn't take Sindri's whetstone. Maybe we'll even find the whetstone.
Remember what I told you about expectations, boy.
Keep them low. I remember. Still, good feeling. Good feeling. I was ready for them this time.
I saw.
So I should keep my expectations low, but always expect an attack?
It is a delicate balance. Expect the worst, assume nothing, and always anticipate an attack.
Sure is a lot to remember. Still no whetstone. And only one room left. I know I shouldn't hope, but do you think we'll find it there?
No.
Back to piss on my corpse, you ungrateful little...
Who are you two?
We're looking for a whetstone. Have you seen it?
Aye, there was one in this room. My son sharpened his dagger on it, right before stabbing me in the back.
What?
Little bastard thought it was his turn to lead my crew. I was hard on him, sure. Guess I shouldn't be surprised. I did the same thing to my dad when I was his age.
He killed his own father?
Where is he now?
He may be a bastard, but he's my bastard. You'll get no help from me, fool.
Then his dagger will help.
Hey! That's mine! Hey!
Come, boy. We are leaving.
Oh!
Son betray him like that? Kill his own father? Over some treasure? It seems so greedy.
Remember what I told you, boy. Assume nothing.
Well, sure. You didn't seem like a great father, but...
You only know half the story.
Yes.
Atreus, here. Atreus, to me!
You, didn't happen to find that.
We found no whetstone. This dagger belongs to the Reaver who took it.
They took most of the good stuff.
Oh? Well, here, take this, in exchange for the dagger. Dagger you brought me is quite interesting, an artless design, but the construction is sound. Where in the temple did you find this?
In Ariver's back.
Oh.
He mentioned he was part of a larger clan. Maybe they took the whetstone?
Quite possibly. I know I've seen this design before. I have a favor to ask. Just a small favor, really. Do you remember the dagger you gave me?
The dagger stabbed into the Reaver's back? His own son killed him? Yeah, I haven't forgotten that one.
Well, I traced it to a group of Reavers that operate out of the Northree Stronghold. I'd wager that's where they took their haul from Fafnir's storeroom, along with that whetstone that I could use to help you. What speaks to you?
Another treasure hunt? Pointless.
Well, not if Sindri really can make us better equipment with that whetstone. Plus, the Reaver's son. He murdered his father.
Well, don't buy anything on my account.
why do they call Odin the Lord of the Hanged?
That refers to a modest example of Odin's thirst for knowledge. The time he spent 9 days a dead man. Hung himself by the neck from Yggdrasil's branches, put his spear through his own side, and bled down into the Well of Destiny. He roamed the realms of the dead and plundered the World Tree of its secrets, until I think, quite rightly, it got fed up with him and sent him back to the land of the living. Did I not mention he was barking mad?
These bones pulse with magic.
It must be Golvi. Could we just hold on to it? Maybe we'll find the rest of them.
His spirit lies to you, boy.
How would you know?
I have known many spirits. They are all liars.
This one is different. I know it.
You know very little.
Fafnir. I always wondered what became of him.
Wait, Fafnir? Like, Fafnir's storeroom Fafnir?
The very one.
But Sindri said he was a dwarf.
He was. And now he's a dragon. Funny how life works, isn't it? Keep an eye out for binding shrines and free the poor bastard. Aye, lads?
How did your friend become a dragon, Mimir?
Oh, he's no friend of mine. This little scroat was a constant source of annoyance amongst Aesir and Vanir alike.
Then why free him?
Trust the recently liberated brother. No one deserves to be held captive like this. Even a greedy little dwarf come dragon. Magical artifacts had something to do with it. He's stolen a trinket from the wrong Vanir goddess.
Ah!
Changed since we last crossed paths. I had legs. Go, you wee little bugger. Well, the dragon hasn't done much for his personality.
Trusting a spirit to keep its word is foolish, boy.
But if there's even a chance, don't you want to see Mom again?
Of course I... She is gone, Atreus. You must accept this.
I do, but to see her again, just one more time.
Why do you believe him? You do not know him or who he was. All of this is sinister.
He wants to see someone he loved again. I understand how that feels. I don't think there's anything sinister about it.
Hope is blinding your instincts, boy.
Mimir, you never did tell me why Freya spit in your face.
Well, she blames me in large measure for her present circumstances. And not totally without reason.
Focus up!
Yeah.
A tough fight.
You want a beach here?
Come and face me, God of Thunder!
Your challenges mean nothing to the gods, Spirit. They do not listen.
Do not mock my pursuit of vengeance. Though my family devoted their lives to worshipping Thor, I've devoted mine to his downfall. And I will start with that statue looming over my father's grave.
Unlikely. You are dead.
Is there something we can do?
For a reward, of course.
If you bring down the statue, you have my blessing to loot my father's grave. He rests on an island to the east.
Why do you hate Thor so much?
After my father passed, my mother built the statue to watch over his grave. Imagine our surprise when the God of Thunder himself came to offer condolences. We were thrilled, but he quickly took advantage of our hospitality. My mother begged him to leave, and Thor, in his drunken rage, killed him. Nothing but grief. Eventually, I lost that as well, and found only rage in its place.
I'm so sorry.
Come on, we have a statue to destroy.
You are one vicious son of a bitch.
Spirit.
The one whose mom was killed by Thor? What about him?
Will his story be a reminder? The lives of men mean nothing to the gods.
I know, Father.
You know. But do you listen?
Yes.
Good.
never did tell me why Freya spit in your face.
Well, she blames me in large measure for her present circumstances, and not totally without reason. It all goes back to the long war between the Aesir and Vanir. Prior to that, wars for the Aesir were easily won, but the Vanir had proved their equal and exacted devastating damage. Both sides suffered tremendous losses, and for many of us, quite frankly, war was simply no fun anymore, but a rather senseless waste of precious life. Wouldn't you agree, brother? Precisely. Enough was enough. And at last, Odin's most brilliant advisor became determined to find a more enlightened path. He set about to broker a peace between the gods. It took some convincing, but ultimately Odin was persuaded to marry his deadliest enemy, a certain Vanir goddess, legendary not only for her magical beauty, but her genius, the very Vanir magic that Odin had long aspired to master.
Not too hard.
Ready yourself!
Run! I need that alchemist for something I'm stewing up for you. If you're smart, you'll find him. And for Junior, keep an eye on that big guy, all right? You again. Now, what was the other thing?
Boy, over here.
Sir. Vaithargar. Southern outposts of the Dwarven King. Dwarven King? Have you ever heard of a Dwarven King?
No.
I'd heard rumors of a powerful dwarf ruling over some poor sods not far from here. Not that you asked me.
What happened to these people?
Follow the clues.
Okay. Well, scorch marks. They're all grouped together. So maybe they were hiding from some kind of fire breather. But they died anyways.
On your right!
Boy.
Yes, sir. Curse the Dwarf King. Bane of mankind. Sounds like he wasn't a very good king. I wonder why they hated him so much.
They are dead now. Does it matter?
No. I'm just curious.
Curiosity is dangerous, boy. Stay focused.
Begin to build statues this big.
Dwarves are resourceful creatures. Annoying, but resourceful.
I guess they must have been pretty important dwarves. Mimir, you're in the middle of a story. Well, here it is. It's gotta have a weak point. Somewhere.
gun.
Find anything good?
Perhaps.
Father, we're going to bring down that statue, right? We're really just going to leave his grave and leave? Story before. Why would Freya agree to marry Odin? What was in it for her?
It was a sacrifice to protect her. A selfless act of love. Truly, she deserved.
That sounds like a dragon. On that island. That must be where the spirit's father is buried.
Follow me, Atreus.
Chained up too? There's something over there.
Boy.
Yes, sir. Another marker. Watch out for the dragon breath.
I am aware of it, boy.
Sure, where you get sad.
Not very many graves here. This must have been a small settlement. The dragon shrine. My mother had a story about three chained dragons. The shrine must be related.
There were three runes on the pedestal.
We've got to find the other two and free them.
It does not concern us.
That's what Mother would have wanted. And it just seems right.
Guard your emotions, boy. Your enemies will not hesitate to use them against you. may attack us and we will be forced to kill it.
You two make quite a formidable duo.
Look here.
Sir.
Looks like the runes on the right side fell off. They must be around here somewhere.
same way.
True. It means to believe or to have faith in. So they still have faith in their king? Even after he got so many of them killed?
It is a command to have faith despite his failures.
Another one here.
It's Skadi. Mother liked her. The great huntress.
That's right. Queen of the hunt, they called her.
That's her father. And all the animals she hunted.
He taught her well.
And the last panel. Her father again. Both of them. In the snow.
And they're still there. It's quite a story.
Please don't eat us.
Boy, prepare yourself.
Huh. You're welcome.
Boy.
The Dwarf King made his subjects hunt dragons and other monsters for him? Some king, huh? Father, you may want to see this. Looks like that lever over there will free him.
He will attack.
I know, but it feels wrong to keep something caged like this.
Your emotions again, boy.
You can't hear their thoughts. I can.
Ignore them, and ready yourself.
Okay. But he was grateful to die in battle, instead of rotting in a cage.
Your skill is improving. You fought well, Atreus.
Thank you, Father. Oh, fresh air feels good. So, what happened to all the people who lived here?
Follow the clues, boy.
Right, right. Follow the clues. Okay, so there was an evil dwarf king, and he made all these people hunt monsters. The people put them in cages, and then... I don't know.
We are missing a clue.
Back inside the castle?
No. There is nothing more for us inside. But stay alert for chained dragons, boy. Perhaps you'll uncover more about this Dwarf King.
Trade those for? Here's something I can't figure out. Odin wants to prevent Ragnar. But the Serpent's already been there and seen it. So hasn't he already failed?
Fate's a tricky thing, lad. And Odin's just arrogant enough to think he can get the best of it.
Fate is another lie told by the gods. Nothing is written that cannot be unwritten.
On that, brother, you and the Allfather may just agree. Even if he can't prevent Ragnarok, he still hopes to learn enough details to influence the outcome. Remind me later to tell you about the wolves.
You scare up that alchemist, what needed finding? Fuck ever. Thank you.
How was your trip to Jotunheim?
Will you give them a little privacy? The kid just found out he's a giant. He doesn't need you interrogating him.
Brock, you knew?
Oh, we knew Faye was the last guardian of the Jotunar left in Midgard. That's why we made her the Axe. We hoped it could restore the balance of power.
After Thor went all Berserk with our hammer.
Though in the end, it seems she chose another path. She chose, well, you. Both of you. I suppose she figured that was the best chance for the Giants to live on. And now, I suppose, that's up to you.
How about that? A young Jotun with us the whole time. And the son of Laufey, the Just! I should have seen it before!
Something else we can do for you?
Nah, just glad you guys worked it out.
Ah. Well, I could say the same to you.
Ha!
I guess I was getting a bit full of myself.
Told him what he needed to hear, how's it sounds to me.
Just the same. I'm sorry for how I spoke to you, Sindri. You forgive me?
Already have. Like you said, it all worked out. Now, let us get back to work before I get sentimental.
Better not be fighting with your brother again.
Just because he's gotten a little less annoying over the years doesn't mean I ain't got a customer base of my own to keep happy.
Oh yeah? Who's that?
Well, you came back here, didn't you?
Fair point.
Atreus, here!
Yes, Father!
I can't believe Odin and Freya were ever married.
And we'll pick this up later.
Nicely done.
Here. Boy.
Yes, sir.
Kaveka.
Enemies ahead!
Done, boys. Never thought I'd see a scrap like that again.
What do you want?
To thank you. These dead Reavers drowned me many winters ago, and I've been itching to see them get theirs.
Useless.
Well, we can't expect them all to know something useful.